All right, starting up some Banjo.
That was quick.
Yeah.
And he's going to be playing Banjo-Kazooie.
Yeah, we might trade off. This is one of the games that we're not dedicated to just one of us playing, so we might swap back and forth.
Well, because Banjo-Kazooie is fun, and also because I haven't played it in so long.
No, you...
I vaguely remember where everything is and how you're supposed to do everything.
You only barely remember it, and I've never played it, so...
Yeah, that's perfect combination.
Obviously, we're going to get through this in blazing quickly.
You don't even get to the actual castle till, like, a tutorial section, so... Oh. It's actually running pretty well.
Man, I wish we could do N64 games without that little lip on the bottom, but whatever.
Bonk.
Oh, hey, Sparks.
Fuck Spyro's Rareware's, like, immediate... Okay, here's the intro.
Sure is cartoony. Oh, that's why it's called Banjo, I get it.
I don't know what a fucking kazooie is, though.
He's got a kazoo.
I guess that's why they call... By the way, the bird's supposed to be a girl.
Yeah.
So, just letting you know that.
I feel like this is music we should have played during that blackout that in Paper Mario.
Oh, really? Yeah, I guess so.
Prior to, I've watched some videos, but most of my knowledge of this character comes from Diddy Kong Racing, so there's very little.
Yeah, that's fair.
Yep, they're happy dancing country bears.
I don't know what, like, nationality they're supposed to be. I just kind of say they're from Canada.
Eh.
Eh. But, alright, that's how... Oh. 2002!
98. That was weird.
We're getting conflicting statements from the game. 2002!
That was weird. Use the control stick.
Select a game, press A to play the game, or Z to erase it. Oh, that one, obviously. Or...
whatever. We'll just do the easiest one. Yo! Yo-yoy!
Alright, you ready for the intro?
Sure. I know this is probably going to be pretty long. I'm familiar with the game, like, the concept, the plot.
Well, just wait, you'll... I am the witchiest witch to ever witch!
My voice can't do that yet.
Yeah. My throat's almost feeling better.
Yeah, well, that's good.
I recover quickly. I don't know what's up with you. You gotta go to the doctor again.
Hey, it's Ganondorf.
Nice. Dingpot, dingpot, by the bitch! Who is the nicest looking witch?
Isn't that kind of derogatory?
Why, it's Grunty! She really takes my breath away.
Grunty Day, is that her last name?
I don't know.
Yes, you're right, I'm rather proud! My looks stand me out from the crowd!
Yeah, she does this the entire game, by the way!
Yeah. I can't be worse than Sakura.
Where is this girl?
What do you mean? This cannot be! There's no one prettier than me! She's too young and small. She's the prettiest girl.
What were you saying about depth?
I'm prettier. No, I'm prettier.
It's more of a comedy. I mean, it's rare. You'll find it's Dewey. She's cute and kind.
I will steal her youth.
We'll get to that.
I know. Again, familiar with the game's plot.
Yeah.
Oh no, Dorothy, don't go into the field of flowers!
Poppies! Basically, they stole the character wholesale from Wizard of Oz and nobody was none the wiser.
Just made her fat.
Yeah. Fat. Fat witch.
Hey, Mr. Rossetti.
Hi. So you hear that chatter? Ow! Wow, you're annoying!
When my big lazy brother wakes up, tell me more, Coco Bandicoot! Nice! 98, that was 3 years before the end of the N64's life cycle. I don't know how long its life cycle was, though.
I don't know. I think...
This wasn't a launch title, right?
I don't think... Hold on.
Check when the N64 launched.
Alright.
Yeah!
Do you think she's fairer than me? I'll steal her looks and ugly she'll be.
Ugly she'll be.
Yes, good job, Yoda.
Is
N64 wiki. Up there in the sky, it's a witch. 97. So a year after it came out.
Okay, so that's not long. It was an early title for the 64.
Yeah. Oh, it had two release dates in the U.S.
Was one in 2002?
September 26th and September 29.
Okay.
One was limited, one was official.
Oh.
Don't scratch and bite, you little bear!
You'll soon need bigger underwear.
I'm freaking out. Oh, Wedgie. Oh. By the way, the bird lives in the backpack.
Ah, Banjo, wake up!
Derpiest voice.
I know, right?
I feel like we had two types of main characters in the 90s. The big dumb ones like Crash and Banjo, and the radical ones like Sonic and Spyro. Honestly, Mario's kind of... He does it better than a lot, but he's also got the big dumb thing going on.
Okay.
Because he's just... His whole shtick is that he speaks broken English and he barely speaks at all.
Yeah. Alright, so you're going to start off knowing...
Let's check the garbage.
You're going to start off not knowing how to do jack and shit, so you're going to want to talk to that aforementioned mole to learn how to do shit.
Okay. I'd better learn how to, like, run and punch and shit. I don't know these things.
Yeah, he doesn't. Like... Listen up, I'm Bottles, the short-sighted mole.
Isn't that redundant?
My buddy Kazooie. Alright, so the dynamic between the bird and the bear is that the bear is a dumb happy dude, and the bird is a smart tsundere bird dude.
Yeah.
Chick.
What was all that noise about? Where's my sister Tootie?
Durr, where's my sister?
Tootie? Floggy? His voice is Big the Cat.
Man, what was Big the Cat actually like?
Wasn't he, who voiced Big the Cat?
I
feel like we looked him up recently because we found out he voiced someone who's actually like way more relevant or like cool or something.
Press A if you want me to teach you some basic moves, or press B if you think you're already.
Nah, I got this.
If you do that, you can actually skip the tutorial.
How long is it?
It's gonna take a video.
Wow, too long. Wow, whole video for, well, whatever. It's content.
Yeah. I mean, you might as well learn how the platforming works in this game.
Yeah. Woo! Wee! Woo! Wee! Woo!
So, there's a lot of molehills throughout. You talk to one of them, you'll get new moves. This happens through, not just through this area, but through, like, the rest of the game, you learn new shit.
Yeah.
Wee-hoo,
this won't get annoying.
Alright. Anyone home?
Look up Big's voice actor. I'm curious about this. Camera controls, those are important.
Voice actor for Big the Cat. That's nothing special. Oliver Wyman.
No, not the current one, the one for Sonic Adventure 2 specifically, or Sonic Adventure 1.
In Sonic Adventure.
Okay. So, Mario 64.
Sonic Adventure 1?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, if you're gonna do camera controls, there's worse you could do at the end of this era than Mario 64.
Well, that was. Almost every platformer on the N64 was based on the engine of Mario 64. Even Zelda was based off the engine of Mario 64.
I think, if I remember correctly, Star Fox 64 was based off of the Mario 64.
And that was a space shooter.
That's a really good... That's like Unreal Engine before it was... That's Gary's...
Pretty much,
that's Gary's mod before it was Gary's
mod. Mario's
mod. That was Source Engine. Alright. Fucking hell, they're just not giving me shit.
Try the Sonic X voice.
Oh, Not until you learn this one. First, you must stand like this.
What a bitch.
Yeah, that's why I said Tsundere. That's basically her character. Big the cat. Sonic X.
Am I missing something?
You have to go...
I can't move.
Oh, you hold Z. Now hit A. There, that's your super jump.
Okay.
First appearance. English. Oliver Wyman.
Okay, well, who else did he voice?
Wow, it took 5 minutes just to... Big the Cat. Okay, I'm just gonna look up Wiki.
Okay, I don't know how to get to that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, is that something I worry about later?
I think you can actually. Okay, you do the Z jump.
Yeah,
there you go.
I thought I was still in Spyro mode.
Yeah, the voice act, the platforming in this game is way more forgiving. I'm gonna tell you this now.
Okay.
There's a lot of ways you can get around, and there's multiple ways you can get from place to place if you so desire.
I think you were just bad at it.
He picked up really quickly, though.
Well, again, Mario 64 engine.
Also, Banjo can swim!
Yeah. Well, he's a bear, not a dragon. Bears can swim. How do you think they catch fish? You saw Brother Bear. Press B to dive.
And then you press A to, like, move.
Like Mario?
I think so, yes. We're basically playing more Mario, but with a deeper, like, with collectibles. More of them. Oh! Press B to, like, swim faster.
Okay, so B is the stroke for Mario 64, and A is the kick for Mario 64. Got it.
Are you complaining about the controls?
No, I'm just making commentary.
Alright, good. Sorry, I accidentally looked up the corporation, Oliver Wyman.
Is that a corporation?
Yeah, subsidiary of Marsh & McLennan Management Counseling, founded in 1840, but became Oliver Wyman in 2007. These guys were behind Big the Cat.
Okay.
All right, Oliver Wyman voice actor.
Getting my honeycomb pieces.
If you get like six.
Honeycomb's big, yeah. You see anything?
Not on Wikipedia. I'm gonna have to go to some other site.
Tell me about flying root muncher. Whoa! Can she say that?
Banjo's just kind of letting her do it, too. It's just like, oh, gee, that's just Kazooie.
It said something about climbing up or down. I didn't
catch it. Oh, no, you're going the wrong way.
Whatever.
Okay.
Do I have to do them in order?
No, but...
Oh, do I get to fight the final boss?
Hey, where are you guys going? We're off to whack the witch! You haven't learned all the basics yet!
I thought he was gonna say she'll kill you.
The bridge is broken and I'm not fixing it until you learn all the moves.
My sister's going to die because of you. Well, or be an old woman.
I don't know, maybe that could kill her. Yeah, good luck. There's falling damage. Be careful.
Bah. Oh, is this the fight club? Can I learn to punch things now? Whee!
You can learn at it.
Beak barge attack.
At least I got some legs. Hold Z, then press B. Oh yeah, that's basically a shoulder tackle. That's just one of many ways you can attack in this game.
Wow. She's useful for something.
Break all of them, you get a honeycomb piece.
Ah, crap. I don't care.
All over.
The rocks have eyes. I'm killing. Are the honeycomb pieces like tutorial tracking progress?
You get six of them. You get an extra container, health container.
Okay.
They basically act as heart pieces.
I'm aware that this game is a collect-a-thon. I know that much.
Yeah. It doesn't hurt to collect anything because it's all collectibles serve a purpose.
Yeah.
It's not just empty shit.
I finally learned to attack shit.
Okay, so there's two ways to attack. You stand still and you hit B, he punches. You move forward, you I think you only have access to the punch for now, but... Yeah.
That looks like it's such a sissy slap. That's like the Luigi slap.
Well, it's a bear. He's clawing him. I want some moves.
You already got some.
All right. Oh, finally got Oliver Wyman, the voice actor.
Shoulder check.
He's also known as Pete Zartacoustica.
Okay, but no other roles you're seeing.
I'm looking. No, I've seen a bunch of them. One piece is Django.
Oh, that's where we found him, probably.
Yeah. Onion. Let's see.
Ball.
We're fighting. You're fighting vegetables.
Sure am. What is this, Maple Story?
Siegfried von Schroeder. He was in Cat Dog as additional voices.
Okay, I remember that show.
Right there, the mouse named Winslow with the Cockney accent!
He was Big the Cat in Lego Dimensions.
Okay, there's Lego Sonic as a thing?
I guess so!
I have a peck attack. Else?
Oh, he does a lot of audiobook narrations.
Okay. That's cool, I guess.
Including there's something called Atomic Lobster, which sounds awesome. Oh, you learned all the moves?
Yay!
Okay.
You thought that was a whole video?
Well,
you
should at the very least get like six.
Is there more around here?
Yeah. There's one underwater. If you didn't get it yet. Wow, it just pauses every time you hit somebody.
Yeah, for effect. Conquer is the same kind of... The same kind of world structure as this is. I'll say that much.
Okay.
And we are planning to do Conquer, too.
Yeah.
But probably after we finish at least Banjo-Kazooie. Maybe the both games.
Maybe if you like this enough. I mean...
Well, you're the one who's going to be playing Conquer. Wait,
yeah.
Then again, we could trade off on it, because neither of us have played it.
Neither of us have.
But
I've watched it.
Yeah, I've seen video of it.
Yeah, frame rate's not too bad.
Yeah. It's handling it better than it handled Paper Mario.
Oh my god.
Paper Mario is a very complex game.
That it's like... this is Nintendo 64 likes these, like, 3D environments. It just loves them. If you try to do something, like, with layers and shit, like Paper Mario doesn't know what to do.
Yeah, that was a late N64 game. Is there stuff in Banjo's house? Is it like Donkey Kong Country?
You can check. I don't remember. Probably not.
Woo!
Yeah!
Puzzle piece? Do I get a jiggy now?
You're not supposed to know what those are yet!
Oh, I'm sorry. I have a picture of the mole in my house.
The mole that I didn't know who he was until today.
Didn't we just meet? No.
Oh, that's who... Aren't my roots in your house?
So that's who my landlord is.
Yeah, there's nothing in here. Just go.
No. That's another thing that we're going to do. Hopefully soon is Donkey Kong Country. We're talking about it.
Oh, yeah.
I'm
going to
go through
fun.
That series, and then
we'll get back
then we can do 64.
Yeah.
That'll be...
The ultimate collect-a-thon!
Clearly. I've never played 64.
I have. It's not as good as Banjo-Kazooie.
Yeah. It has a lot of nostalgia behind it, but... That's for people who grew up with it. I did not.
DK.
Get the fuck back here!
Yeah, this has physics, kind of. Mildly.
Can you agree with me when I say that the DK rap is objectively worse than the One Piece rap?
Yes, you may.
You'll I can
find
stuff.
Plenty of other things.
Like in Mario 64.
Oh, hey, you learned how to climb things.
There we go.
You didn't collect all the empty honeycomb pieces, though.
I didn't.
Yeah, I know. If you collected all of them, you would have gained 6 containers instead of just 5.
You're positive that there are 6 that many in this.
Yes,
in this
I'm
area. Okay.
Positive.
Okay.
Where's your exploration spirit?
I feel like I've gone everywhere. This is more.
You've gotten one from here, I feel.
I know. Camera, come on.
If you hit up on this, yeah, there you go.
It is a controlled camera location. Gonna live my life in a hole from now on.
Bottles already does. That is the same texture they used in Ocarina of Time, I feel.
For the flowers?
Yes.
There better not be some shit like I have to, like randomly find one in the grass or something.
I don't think they're that sadistic. It's not up there.
Are you sure?
Oh, there's extra life though.
Is that what that is?
Yep.
I'm an extra life.
Yep.
I'm a bear. I want to raid the garbage. Come on.
Fight back, your predatory. It's... Come on, Yogi.
Boo Boo runs wild. Have you seen that?
Oh yeah, the one where Boo Boo just decides to go.
That was like an Adult Swim like skit.
They could get away with it because, you know, that's a Turner Network thing.
Yeah.
Remember when cartoons had laugh tracks? That was weird.
Yeah.
Well, you climbed the waterfall for that one. I assume one's up on a tree somewhere, since you can climb.
I got one there.
Since you can climb trees, I assume one is, like, on a tree.
Yeah. I didn't check out the higher point of the river.
You can try that. Yeah.
I haven't climbed this tree. Come on, tree.
There you go. There we go! Okay, now you can
continue.
You're gonna need lives. You're gonna need help, because if you lose all your lives, you better hope you've saved recently.
Yeah. The music is very carefree.
Yeah, it is a very carefree game.
So, personality-wise, this Banjo really is Big the Cat. He just has, like, a salty tsundere alongside him. Big and Amy's excellent adventure.
Great. Ooh, time to the out. We sure are! Show us the way, Bottle Boy! Bottle doesn't seem to really care.
Yeah. Gruntilda.
Thanks, Bottles.
So her full name is Gruntilda Day, I guess.
I don't know if the last one's I know it's Gruntilda. Here we go!
Final boss!
Welcome to the hub world!
Yeah.
That was just a training area. This is the hub world now. But... this fine contraption, so I'm told.
Will make me young and tootie old!
Kurosuchi's sister sure is weird.
Yeah, I kinda have the same voice for Kurosuchi, Frieza, and witches.
Hurry, Klondo, press that switch! I'm tired of being an ugly bitch!
Yes! Yes!
Yes, mistress!
Igor! There is no time limit for this game.
Yeah. Just gotta wait for it to start up. Oh, hold on, it's stalling.
First level is to your right. Oh, you can go left if you want to, but you're not gonna.
Oh, look, a painting!
They did repurpose the assets in a creative way. I never really put two and two together when I was a kid.
You mean the engine?
Yeah.
Oh. I wonder what this is!
Hey, it's me, Mr. Jiggy!
Howdy ho! Okay, why not?
Yeah, those are the ones that actually unlock worlds.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you get them from worlds, but They're required to access other worlds.
You collected puzzle pieces in Croc as well to unlock secret levels.
Yeah, well, they've Rare learned a lot since dealing with Croc.
Rare didn't do Croc.
Oh, yeah, they didn't?
No, that was Argonaut Studios or something.
Oh, that's weird. Well, then there's... Okay, so, yeah, you go to a painting, you finish the painting, you unlock the world. That's how that works.
Take over for just a sec.
Okay. You want to just cough away? So, Xelrog has just left. I'm taking over, so... Oh, yeah. That... To enter the world shown on the picture, you must... Yep.
If... Just half the time... Is it just... I guess it's only... He's the only character we've seen thus far who's not Gruntilda, but... Seems like every time Kazooie talks to someone, she says something boy. So I'm just gonna imagine her talking like Pegasus. Goggle boy.
All right. Of course, other levels will have steeper puzzle piece requirements.
Obviously. Back to me.
Yeah. I don't think that was such... Also, some sections... Okay, don't go in the level yet. Just go down the other path, because I want to show you something. Judy says she's fine with me. If you go home, I'll set her free. Technically, she's not wrong.
Is there a way to move faster at all?
Jumping. Or doing that.
Okay, so... Oh, fuck.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You gotta unlock a... Okay. So you do get an ability that lets you go up there, but you also need to collect all, like, musical notes in the level, because there are doors that require you to have, like, a certain maximum combined through all levels in order to get past them.
Okay, so faster movement is the Zelda method. Roll and jump.
You also get faster movement another way. You get it from this level. There are three new moves to learn in this world.
Oh, look! A random critter!
Yep.
I'm just gonna maul it, because I'm a fucking bear.
Levels here have multiple jigsaw pieces and, Oh,
okay, I couldn't maul that one.
You collect five of them.
Jinjos. I'm saving gingers?
You collect five, they're the red coins of this game.
Okay.
I have a note. One of... They all talk!
Huh?
Yeah, that's how you have to have notes to have to, like,
get so many the talking course. Collectibles.
Yeah.
Conker does this, but ironically.
Well,
Conker's basically
this, but unironically.
Conker's basically a parody of Banjo-Kazooie, which is why we're doing this one first.
Yeah, you wouldn't be able to get out of the- Why are you leaving?!
I didn't know that would do that.
Stops you taking the notes off. So now you gotta collect them again.
Okay, well I didn't get very far, thankfully. I thought it'd be like Spyro and you have to press a button to go on or something. Okay, so 100 coins for a first star.
Yeah.
Wait! Nope, too late. Was I supposed to like talk to the ant or something?
No. No, okay. So here's what you need to get... In this game, you need to get everything in one go.
Yeah.
You need to get all the Jinjos in one go to get a Jiggy. You need to get all the note pieces in one go to get a Jiggy. It doesn't save, like, how much you got.
Yeah.
It only saves your maximum totals.
I have heard this music track specifically before. This was, like, used a lot in Newgrounds flashes.
That makes sense.
90s!
Okay. Right, so...
Ah!
You missed. Fuck.
This is so wacky, so cartoony.
Andrew, does we cartoon win?
Da 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 da.
All right, so.
Oh look, spiders. Ah! Oh, I missed.
Nice job.
That's okay, I can maul it. Oh, it takes multiple hits.
Yep. That one was bigger, that's why.
Banjo for Smash 5.
Banjo-Kazooie, Nintendo basically disowned the Banjo-Kazooie franchise after it went to Microsoft.
Yeah. That, there's a whole thing with Rare.
Yeah.
Would be cool, though.
It would be cool.
Have, like, Banjo-Kazooie have the perfect dark guy. Pass my best Stone note Age. Score of 3.
Oh.
Eggs, too.
Fuck you. Eggs are basically ammo.
Okay.
10 of us on each world. Gonk.
Oh, I got my jiggy. I'm done here, obviously.
Nah. Oh, only one jiggy.
Only one thing to collect, that's plenty. You say this game's more forgiving with the platforming, but it's a lot less forgiving with the collectibles, obviously, than Spyro.
Oh, no. Yeah, whereas Spyro had, like, really tight platforming, but the collectibles really didn't mean anything, here has pretty forgiving platforming, and the collectibles are important as fuck.
I don't think it was that tight. The Talon Trot? Well, look, is the Louis Talon. Okay, I already got up there, but okay.
Hold Z, then press the left C button. Okay, so that allows you to move quicker, and it also allows you to climb steep slopes. Because, you know, talons. You can jump while in that state, too.
Okay. But I have to keep holding Z. If I let go, then it's gone.
Yes. Not that bad. It just means you can't use other abilities that use Z.
Yeah.
But platforming actually gets a bit easier. As long as you don't need to double jump.
Can you imagine if Kazooie was voiced by Gilbert Gottfried?
Kazooie's supposed to be a woman, so
I
no. I can't imagine.
Ah, but does that really matter?
Gilbert Gottfried?
Jafar, I did all I could!
I forgot he was Iago.
Fucking Gilbert Gottfried reading 50 Shades of Grey.
Yeah.
Oh, it's an ape escape.
Chimpy,
I better...
Chimpy hungry!
Better
What's
catch
orange
it?
Now? Feed Chimpy.
I'm gonna maul it! No, I can't maul it.
Chimpy wants an orange.
Well, Chimpy, you're gonna have to learn that sometimes you don't get what you want.
The strongest.
Come here. No, you can't throw that far. You
don't
suck.
Don't touch Conga's blocks, so... Okay, that's a block saying that that's an orange. He's throwing oranges.
Oh, is that an orange? I couldn't tell. There we go. Big dumb ape boss. I think Donkey Kong 64 came out before this. Was that a launch title?
No, Donkey Kong 64 totally came out after this.
Oh, okay.
Oh, you can steal it. Just climb the tree and get his orange, I guess. Okay. That conga's orange.
Nah. The oranges are alive.
Chimpy likes conga's orange. Maybe Banjo's not an idiot. Maybe he's just on all the psychotropics.
I wonder if that's the same monkey noise from Majora's Mask.
Maybe. So, okay. So, I think you get it. There's another ability up here. See the molehill? Yeah. Go for it.
Okay, so are the molehills always new abilities from this point on?
Yeah. They'll always be new abilities.
Oh, God, the game can't handle this. Too many eggs.
This game trusts you to, like, not, like, require constant hits.
Ancient ways of eggs.
Hold Z. Then press top C to shoot an egg out of your mouth.
Ew. Sounds painful.
Yeah, it's useful for other things.
Exciting, huh?
So, you start off... You can carry a maximum of 100. Alright, try to shoot the monkey with it. Nope. You can fire. You can do a burst of three.
Ow. I didn't know how many hits he took. He was still talking, he wouldn't shut up.
Yeah. Don't touch Konga's blocks.
Oh, the game is shitting itself all of a sudden. Uh-oh, wrong.
Yeah! Awesome Matrix dodge, bro! Bear beats Konga.
Technically, the bird beat you. More gold. Just for good measure.
He's not gonna care. You're 40% done with the level.
Yay. So is each level gonna be a video in this?
Oh, I think some levels are gonna require multiple videos. I think you're gonna have to want to see the shaman.
Yeah? Me and Mumbo's talking.
I guess you can't grab onto things until the next game.
Oh, do you have ledge grabbing in two?
Yeah.
Can I do anything with this yet?
You need to learn an ability to do that.
Okay.
It's a ground pound, basically.
Ah.
Go away! Leave my honeycombs alone!
Okay. Oh. Okay, that was what I was supposed to do. No punishment from bees.
That's not until the next game. Oh no! El Toro!
El Toro loco. What, El Toro fuerte?
Yes.
Never removes his mask.
You got him.
You're gonna get mauled by a bear or something.
You need to get the other ability first, the ground pound.
Oh, fine.
To finish him.
Guess I can only piss him off for now.
Help! Oh, only two left.
Oh, come on.
I think as far as I know... trying to remember if this game is dickish enough that you need abilities to get it before you can complete a level. I don't think this game is that sadistic off the bat, but I know it totally pulls that shit in Banjo-Tooie.
Really forgiving with the air supply.
Yeah, and I think in later games you can actually extend that air supply and or circumvent it entirely.
Yeah.
There's one level that was just entirely underwater in Banjo-Tooie, and you had to, like, do some shit to oxygenate the water so you don't drown while breathing underwater.
Remember that sewer level in Ratchet & Clank? The water kept rising as you were going through the pipes?
Oh, that sucked. Remember, Z...
Yeah, Z down?
Z left. You just shat out an egg.
Sure did. Can I pick it up again?
Yeah, you can, actually can.
Collected enough notes to break the first note door?
Yeah. Like I said, you need notes to circumvent doors in this game. Oh!
I'm on a roll! I saw it. Because I'm observant.
I'm the best treasure hunter ever!
How many? We haven't dropped any frames. The game's just kinda...
It's just doing that.
Yeah. Can't handle this N64 processing power.
Yeah, this, it was just so much fun to just play through this game and just have fun just exploring everything.
Where we're going, we don't need roads! Don't care, collecting puzzles. Or notes.
Oh, it's a tiki torch.
Hey, Mumbo, I'm sure I'll meet you pretty soon.
Okay, see the molehill?
Yeah, I saw a molehill. I'm still exploring! Okay, I'll get the molehill.
You can go into that ant's nest, I guess.
Gotta kill things first. That's really forgiving if every enemy you kill gives you health.
This game is forgiving in some ways, not so forgiving in the others. It's very interesting.
Yeah. It doesn't seem challenging in the platforming sense or in the fighting sense, but in the collect-a-thon tedious sense.
I'm gonna tell you right now, Banjo-Kazooie is a much better game than Banjo-Kazooie.
Yeah.
Like,
I'll tell you now, Spyro 2 is a better game than Spyro 1.
I think we've come to an accord.
You'll be using it a lot. So this is the ground pound.
Yeah, ground pound toggles switches and destroys stones from above. Try using it on those huts.
Mumbo.
Ingum bokum.
I'm a home wrecker.
Yeah.
These don't have like a timeout where they flash and disappear. Do they?
Those, I don't think so. Having said that, don't risk it. If you encounter something and you don't know what to do, try everything is my suggestion.
Yeah. I mean, it does seem interesting that just sheer number of moves in this game.
Oh, and we haven't even scratched the surface.
I'm sure.
And all the moves that you get in this game, most of them, I'm pretty sure all of them, are kept to Banjo-Kazooie. You don't lose any moves.
At the, like,
the start, and they add more moves.
At the start of the game, you
yes.
have all the ones.
Okay. Yes.
Well, that's cool. Can you imagine if that Ratchet and Clank were like that? Every start of every game, you had all the weapons from the previous game.
Yeah, I could. That's one. There's another one.
They do that in Spyro. You unlock moves in 2, and then in 3, you have all the moves that you unlocked in 2.
But see, I like it when they do that. Like, they encourage people to be inventive rather than just reuse the same ideas over again.
Yeah. I am Mumbo. Good jiggy. Fuck. Wasn't trying to do that.
It's fine. I don't remember if there was anything up there or not, but...
Why do I climb the Mumbo head? Because it's there.
Because it's cool. Scary skeletons. Alright. We juju, Mumbo's totem pole. Feed us with nice loose stones.
Okay.
Gotta get it. You're on the right track, though.
That's another game that I feel like I could stream is Attack of the Power of Juju, which was actually a pretty good game, except for one spot of it I've never been able to get by.
Oh, really? You never beaten it?
No, I've never beaten it. Because there's one point in the game where you need to collect the collectibles.
This is really just kicking. Okay, there you go.
And one of the areas you have to collect those collectibles is like a downhill snowboarding thing that you can retry over and over again. And it's just so incredibly vast and actually difficult that I've never been able to find all of them there.
Yikes. Alright.
Come on, Mumbo, let me meet my ally.
Mumbo Jumbo. Is his full name.
I, Mumbo Jumbo, will not be defeated
me
by
Mumbo,
you, Banjo.
Best shaman in all game, can help Banjo and... You are on the right track. Watch it, hot boy.
Watch it, Yugi boy. Magic tokens by which. Find tokens and I, Mumbo Jumbo, will
Banjo's
help
not,
you.
Banjo's not got enough tokens for Mumbo magic. Look at sign, bring more. Look at sign! Bring more! One more thing! I think...
Uncle doesn't really speak in that broken English, though.
Yeah. No, he...
One more thing!
One more thing! Okay,
You want Tootsie turn into old woman?
Then
you bring Uncle Tokens!
His ability's important because he can turn you into an ant in this level.
Yeah?
And that allows you to get into Jiggy, so...
Okay. Is this an anthill?
Yes.
Am I gonna get kicked out if I'm not an ant? I'm guessing that's what happens.
Hey, ugly! No bears allowed!
I don't care killing you. Oh.
But, remember.
I know.
Unless it doesn't work.
Oh, hey.
Ingum bokum.
Work with me.
Pretty sure you do keep Mumbo skulls at... Yeah, that's just too steep. That's basically vertical.
Hang on, I almost made it. I got this.
I know you don't got this because I know the right way to finish that puzzle.
I know, but I feel challenged now.
Oh, it's on!
Come on, game.
You see one more skull and you can get up there.
I know, one more try. One more real try.
Yeah.
Fine.
You did better than I did when I was trying to get up there as Banjo. Okay, so you got all the moves. You're at 8 jiggies, right? Yeah? So one involves... So at this point, one involves getting up the anthill and just getting that one, and one involves finding a Jinzo. There you go.
Well, that was fast.
And I think the rest of the musical notes are up there too, so...
In the anthill?
Yeah.
Okay.
And if not, it's fine. You can miss like 10 and still be- Oh! There it is! Okay, never mind!
Woo! Woo! Hot, 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 hot!
Yeah, there you go! You got it!
Was that a jiggy?
The jiggy was spawned and you just didn't pick it up.
Oh, it spawned where I was just then?
Yes!
Okay,
it always does that.
I'll go back.
You're doing
Shut
pretty
up,
well.
I'm having fun!
I know you are. I haven't seen you enthused by one of my game suggestions for quite a while.
Well, I mean, you know, platformers are my thing. You know this.
Yes. I'm utterly astonished that you and this game is like Romeo and Juliet, just star-crossed lovers.
Well, I mean, it's very pick-up-and-play for a guy who played a bunch of N64 platformers.
Yeah.
Because they're all based on the same fucking game.
It's requiring... I haven't had to take the controller from you once,
yeah,
so that's
you haven't
good.
Gotten angry this video yet.
No.
Running, running, running. Where was Mumbo?
He was up on the top of the hill. Not down here with the monkey.
Oh, right. I have the ground pound, too, now.
Oh yeah, you might want to hit that switch, because that's useful in, like, opening up. Where's fun of, like, double and triple locking things?
Yeah.
We put our hearts and souls in this level, and you're gonna see every goddamn fucking frame of it.
Alright, overworld jiggy.
Yeah.
Or hub world jiggy. Come on, Kazooie, you're doing the work now. Oh. Hold on, I gotta take out a bull.
I think maybe you can't kill it. I know that.
Well, I'm sure as hell gonna try.
Wow, its corpse can hurt you!
No, it just bounces me back.
Alright, well then you can't kill it.
Come here, bull. Over here.
Then you- I-
Over here, bull. Come on, charge.
If you die, that's gonna suck for you. You got it. It's not killing it.
Damn it. Fine. I guess it's just there.
Keep in mind my memory of this game is not 100%, so... Actually, I changed my mind. These Banjo and Kazooie aren't Canadian. They're just from the Pacific Northwest.
Okay, because they're a bear?
Well, that and the fact that it begins in such a Pacific Northwest-y locale. That makes any sense?
I mean, there aren't a lot of trees around. Maybe a couple.
Talk about the overworld, but... What are you saying, that Banjo's from Denver?
I don't know.
Banjo has plenty of tokens. End on skull and press B to...
Will Kazooie do? No. Damn it. Gotta be Banjo. I, Mo Jumbo, will now bless you with powers.
Yes. Mumbo's magic reach. Termite. Alright, so abilities, you can cling to any surface. I think ants will leave you alone now.
Still jump.
Yeah, of course. I don't think you can attack, so be wary.
Oh, I can't fire eggs.
Oh.
I guess it fused me and Kazooie into one.
It does, yeah.
Kinky. Woo!
Oh.
Banjo-Kazooie and Crash make just such a power couple.
Banjo and Kazooie and... like the two of them just want the crazy bandicoot and the chill bear.
Yeah.
Hey, where'd you get those shorts?
Oh, they can still hurt
me. Oh, he can, but he's not actively trying to hurt you.
Yeah.
Get away from those notes!
Hit and run. You'll never see me coming.
Can you move?
Yeah!
Please move. One more. Please move. Go, just go get it! There, you got it!
All 100 notes.
Now you never have to come back here for notes ever again.
I take good notes. Oh!
I guess if you're below a certain threshold, rather than make an annoying sound, it just shows you, hey, look! You're almost dead!
I haven't taken fall damage once yet.
It can happen.
I know.
I'm just telling you that, that if you just decide to jump off a ledge just to be cool guy, you're gonna get hurt. And it doesn't limit it to just one.
I got, that's okay, I got Kazooie.
Yeah, Kazooie does make for a great air break. If you happen to fall and you haven't used, like, the two jumps, you can just bring her out and just kind of prevent yourself from taking damage. Like I said, the platforming in this game is very forgiving.
This roof above me is proving problematic.
You want me to give it a shot?
Nah.
Alright.
Oh, that's another thing. Someone mentioned on the stream, actually. And, something I need to figure out how I'd go about playing it, but I want to play the Tony Hawk games on stream.
Oh, yeah, those are fun. We got a lot of... I mean, it's just a matter of just hooking them up to the...
Yeah, I'd have to hook the Dreamcast up and set it up to composite. And can we... Yeah, we can do composite now.
Yeah, we have that device.
We have the technology. I just wanted to check if there was anything over there.
Yeah, fair enough. I mean, this is the kind of game where that kind of stuff really helps.
Whee! Woohoo! Woohoo!
Oh! Hey.
Oh, it doesn't refill life, though.
I don't think extra lives actually carry over, sadly.
Now, can I safely get down without... Do I have to go down through again?
Can the ant take damage?
Ah!
Nope? No. Okay, cool.
One way to find out! What if I just leave the level like this?
Then the spell will just he'll just not transform on his own. No, like if you get to a certain point away from the level entrance, then he'll just transform back.
Yeah.
I mention this because there are certain points where
wake up, asshole!
Where you can actually take your summon, like your transformation, out of level to get bonus jiggies.
Oh.
So yeah.
Maybe I should have tried that.
No, it doesn't happen here.
No, I can't use it to climb up the wall and get that overworld jiggy.
You're right, go back there.
I'm on point here.
Good job. I legitimately forgot that's how you got the jiggy, because that is a steep-ass cliff.
Bye! I'm gonna abuse this power.
This game's all about abusing powers.
I, Mumbo Jumbo, forbid you from taking this power out of the level.
Fuck that!
Yeah, it's not like he forgives you, it's the more that it grows weaker the more you go away from him.
This is a secret forbidden technique. We can abuse the shit out of it? Fuck yeah!
So we're done. We're totally done here, right? Am I safe to
hit
go?
Hit start. Yeah, we're totally done here.
Okay.
10 jiggies, 100 jigsaw pieces, or 100 notes. Now climb up that fucking... Your best note score for this world is now 100!
Woo!
Alright, now you're done with the Mumbo Jumbo's Mountain. Now I guess just...
Not enough. So we know... I have 10 jiggies. I want to know where the next level is.
You're gonna have to go further in. The hub world is the hub.
We have to go deeper.
Yes, you do. Fortunately, you now have the ability to climb up that steep path that was blocking you the last time.
As a termite!
Aww. No. Mobile magic weak, animal turn back, or magic go.
Nah, that's fine.
Magic all gone. Must go back to Baron Bird now.
Weird fusion technique.
Like, I mean, Mumbo is actually helpful.
Yeah.
There you go.
Gee, I can't imagine why Kazooie never got her own game. She's so charming.
Yep. This is a note door sealed by Grunt. Open it up, Jam Charles. Yep, we know this though.
So I would have to have.
Oh! Bottle also automatically heals you.
I would have to have 50 in. At least 50 in every level.
At least 50. At least.
Combined across all levels.
Yes.
Okay.
So you have 100, which means you can just automatically break this door. But if you got 100 in this level and got 10 in another level, you have a total of 110.
Yeah.
See how that works? Alright, cool.
That's what I was confirming.
Yeah. Also, remember to hit save and quit, not don't just quit.
Yeah.
That door was easy, you got past. Fortunately, you're first and last!
Oh look, something to kill. I missed.
There you go, you got him.
Can I just kill Igor?
Seems like it. Oh, there's the next level.
The desert? Aw, oh, fuck deserts.
No, it's not a desert!
What's up here? Did I remember where I came in?
No, that's not where you came in.
Okay. I'm gonna explore a little bit and then we'll shut down because we're about that now.
The next level is the beach level, the island level.
Ah! Fuck! I fell.
Slightly. Fortunately, there's vines. I like the dynamic music in this.
Lots of exploring to do.
Yeah.
It does seem like they were trying to make music a pretty prominent theme of the game.
Oh, I thought that they were successful. It's why I appreciate, like, dynamic music in games, because this one did really well. Oh, another one! You don't want to waste your jigsaw pieces on here. You're not going to open this level until... This is an end-of-game level right here.
Okay.
And not only that, but the Switch hasn't even been unlocked yet. Here, you can see the name of the painting if you look at it.
Click Clock Wood.
Literally the last level of the game.
Like TikTok clock.
What?
Hello. Are you my fairy godmother?
I'm Brindilla. Brindilla's nicer sister. She never shows up in any other game but this one.
Okay.
Literally!
Ew.
This is actually kind of important. Like, you can just... Like, they may seem useless now, but they actually are important.
Okay. Hog breath. Okay, should I be, like, taking notes?
If you want. I mean, this will all be recorded for posterity, so...
Yeah.
Worst case scenario... Yep, and then
okay,
repeats.
And then she just...
So you get 3 per every appearance, and she appears in multiple places.
So if I come back here later, she's still gonna be here for reference?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Getting some mumbo-jumbo. This music sounds familiar. Like, this riff sounds like it's from something.
And you've heard it before. Throughout the rest of the game. It's dynamic music.
No. From something else. Like, it's another song. I can't... I just... Off the top of my head, I always
knew it from this game. Wanna turn up. Alright, so yeah, you don't have to worry about that area until way later in the game.
This looks promising.
Okay. This should be your next level.
Oh, I thought it was elsewhere.
I know, but the way to open it, the painting is back in the other way, and back in the other room. But this is where you actually enter the level.
Okay.
Is here.
And now it's pirate themed.
Yeah, like I said, tropical island. Oh, you bear! Get away!
I guess I need to learn the ability to fire myself from a cannon.
It's
my guess.
I guess unlock the level and then we'll stop.
Yeah.
Not up there. It's back in the other room. You're just not going.
I'm exploring.
I guess.
Sewer level.
This
looks very Crash Bandicooty.
Yeah, close. Yeah, you're right. It is kind of a. Let me think.
I don't feel like swimming that far.
I think I know what level that is. That one is. So. And there I think is like. What's in there?
Wasn't sure if I could go in there or not.
You can. It's better to check and be in.
I know, I just
made a fool.
In a lot of games, it would just be like the automatic, the current would sweep you away. Oh, fuck you.
This is a game in which the main dickish just comes from being like, oh, you haven't seen the whole area.
I know.
Oh, nice. Unfortunately, I don't think there's anything up here.
Oh,
no!
Come here. That's a happy cauldron.
You've activated a magic cauldron. Find two of the same color to create a shortcut.
Okay, that sounds useful.
Very. Keep in mind that every time you start, you load your save, it puts you at the very beginning of the hub world.
Yeah, like the entry area?
Yeah.
Banjo's house.
No, not Banjo's house. Just the beginning of the...
Okay, yeah, when you enter Gruntilda's domain.
Yes, yes.
It's a pretty expansive witch's lair.
Yeah, it's kind of impressive, no? This is...
They look like Texas.
Shock jump disc. Find me and I'll tell you how to use another ability you unlock later.
Does this game have mini games?
Not yet.
Okay. Banjo-Tooie, I take it?
Yes. With tuna ice cream flavored tooth... See, this is just ridiculous.
Yeah.
It's like... Watch her with ingenuity. Sacky Maggie.
Okay. Oh, I tried to do the long jump from Mario 64.
Not in this game, I'm afraid.
Okay. Well, that was uncalled for.
Oh, it's,
That's another... Was that the one red?
No. Oh. This is purple. This one's purple, the other one was, like, red. Oh. This is a game made for people with OCD.
Yeah. That tends to be the thing with collect-a-thons.
The nicest bear. Just... Duh, huh?
Back in the place
you're
I
by
was.
This first note door, so you've gone too far back.
Yeah.
I mean, a mini map would help, but unfortunately, Rare doesn't believe in them.
Better camera would help too. All right, let's unlock this thing.
Woo! It requires two.
Treasure Trove Cave.
To remove pieces you already put down, press the down C button.
Change my mind, I want to go to a different level.
But once the picture is complete, the pieces are stuck there. Basically, if you don't have enough and you, but for that one, but you have enough for another one, just to make sure you don't accidentally fuck yourself.
Yeah, so you don't link to the past yourself.
Yeah.
We will get to the Zelda series at some point, too, because I need to play Link to the Past, and I want to play Ocarina and Majora.
It'll be fun playing all the games we know on a glitchiest fuck emulator.
Yeah.
Alright, I think
well, Super NES hasn't been bad, the emulator.
No, not
just
that.
N64 has been kind of fucking up.
Well, yeah.
For Paper Mario, specifically. Alright. So that was my first Banjo experience.
Yes. And every time you save and quit, the game guilts you into playing some more.
Okay.
Let me show you how. Are you sure? Press A.
There really is no time limit. Gruntilda's just like...
Don't press anything. Yeah. The time limit is when you hit save and quit. And that's it. Turn it up. I need full power. Yes.
So every time you quit, it's bad end?
Yes.
Okay.
And every time you lose all your lives. Aaron Bird finish, Grunty wins. And... oh, hey, Wooya!
Honestly, she looks better than Lara Croft did on PS1.
And look, Mumbo's just like, give her flower! And...
I guess that's one way to do it. As if anyone would play this entire game in a single run.
No, of course not. You can also...
They wanted to be really sure you saw this scene.
Yeah,
they
for future reference, you can in fact skip it if you just hit A, Matt.
They spent too much time on it for you to not see it.
Yeah. Alright, that was Banjo-Kazooie.
Tried out Spyro, tried out Banjo.
First impressions on Banjo-Kazooie?
I about as... just pretty much what I expected.
Good way or bad way?
I guess it... fairly generic platformer. It was enough that, you know, Conker felt the need to parody it.
Yeah. It'll get better.
Gameplay-wise, it's pretty solid.
Yeah. It's pretty wacky, but...
Oh, God, they're gonna do the song again. All right, cut. Bye, guys!
Bye! No!